Hey, it's John, an Enduring Charm. So last fall, my wife bought some mums that she wanted to put out on the front porch. And, they served their purpose for the fall, for the autumn season there. Of course, we have a real serious deer problem where I live. So you can't leave them out too long. The deer get them. And we had a bunch of storms and they fell all over the yard. They were literally blown halfway across, a couple acres. So, my wife left them for dead, and I picked them back up. And these are the original pots they were in back then. And I thought, well, what the hell? Maybe they'll come back next year. Well, it's now almost July, and they have come back. I'm sure they're root bound in there. They need to be repotted for sure, but they are growing. So I thought, you know what? Let's see if we can do something with these and pretty them up and make something nice for them. So I need to repot them. They're in 1 gallon pots right now, and I'm going to put them in 2 gallon pots. And that should help them, thrive a little bit more. But I have to keep them away from the deer. I can't plant them in the yard because the deer will just eat them. But I can put them on our deck, and I thought, well, wouldn't it be nice to make a little planter? So I went to my local home center. I can't even remember now if I got these at Home Cheapo or Lowe's, but I got some 2 gallon pots, very inexpensive. They're just plastic pots. And I thought maybe I could make some kind of planter made out of wood that I can put on the deck to hold these three pots in a row. And it will look nice, and I could paint it because, maybe I'll paint it white probably just because our deck railing is white as well, and it would look nice. So then I looked around the shop and I found a whole bunch of scrap pressure treated that is left over from various other jobs. So I'm going to use that scrap, and we'll see what we can come up with here. So I'm going to make these in front of you here. At the end, I will stop and give you measurements so you can make something yourself if you like. Now, I don't have a design written down and I'm using scrap lumber, so I'm just gonna kind of wing it and see how it comes out. But I do know I want four individual legs and some slats basically connecting the legs. And I want, so these buckets will show through a little bit. I don't have it, completely solid. They'll just be slats that have some opening. And I want it to be able to drain water, so if I just water the heck out of these things, the water will drain out and not stain the deck. So that's all I really know. So we'll just see how it comes out here. We'll start with the legs. Right, the top of each leg, I have this decorative point going on here. And to make that, all you gotta do is take your miter saw and cut at a 45 degree angle. But you want to do it in the same place each time so that you have a uniform appearance. So it's not difficult to do. The first cut, I'm basically taking a blank here and cutting up to halfway, cutting the 45. So I made a mark on some painter's tape here so I can repeat this. So all I got to do is hold this up to the mark and make my cut. Now I just flip it and again, bring it up to the mark there and make another cut. And so on. Now the last cut, let me just make this one here. The last cut you can either eyeball here or I know it lines up from here to here, so I can just do that if I like as well. Same difference. Okay? All right, with the legs done here, I can kind of push them to the corners here and see how everything's going to line up. Now, what I want to do is I want these buckets to be off the ground. So these legs look longer than they need to be. That's because I want the buckets to be up high like this. So I have airspace underneath here. So any water I put in the buckets drains out and dries out, doesn't stay in the deck. So I could still adjust the length or the size of these legs if I want, but it looks pretty close. So now I just need to figure out a way to get these things off the ground. So I'm going to build basically a little tiny deck and connect it to each leg. All right, I have this is going to be a cross member, and this will make more sense later in the video, so don't freak out. But this is a cross member, and these marks right here are going to be vertical pieces of wood that fit into this cross piece and form the deck, if you will, or the base, the bottom of this planter. So, and I'm just going to nail through from the other side. Now, you can already tell. I mean, I'm not trying to make a china cabinet here. This is just a rustic planter. Now, I'm going to learn you something you might not know. So right here I have a crosscut miter saw. compound miter saw actually. And one feature of some of these, not all of them, but some of them, is this. I can use this to set a depth feature. So if you see, try to get in here, there's a little wing nut right here and an adjustment right here. And right here is a little arm that flips down. If I flip that arm down, okay, now when I pull the saw down, it has a stop and it doesn't allow the blade to go all the way. So I can set this adjustment to whatever I want. So I can use this to make these slots here, this cross-cut dado, if you will. And this is not a saw you might typically associate with that, but it'll work fine. And what I've also done is I've set up this sacrificial fence here, and I made a cut going across here, so I know this is perfectly even with the saw blade, the edge of the saw blade. And because this is a big blade, when I come across here, I want to make sure the blade is at full depth where I'm actually cutting. So if I cut down here in this area here by the actual fence, the metal fence, then I would not be full depth. So this just pushes the workpiece further out and makes sure I have full depth on the blade. All right, so the deck or the base of our planter, I made these slots here, or dados, and then these vertical boards here just fit in there. Now I'm gonna glue and nail those. It's not super critical, there's not a whole lot of weight here, but just to keep them in place. And then the outside gets a board like this. So, and there's one on the other side here. So that'll complete the base. I'll nail that up and glue it and let that be set aside. And then we're gonna figure out a way to attach our legs to the edges here. I'll show you that. All right, I let in the legs with the base here just like I did before. With that saw, and you know, things are looking up. You're seeing now how things are going to look. Now I just have to make the slats that go across, you know, across each leg here. And you may notice, I don't know if you can see it on camera, this leg's a little crooked, but that'll straighten out when I put the slats on. Now I could put the slats on the outside or the inside. I've chosen to do the inside just because I think it looks a little bit better. So I'm gonna basically just cut those to length. I'm not gonna let those in. There's really no need to. So I'm just gonna nail those, you know, from the inside into the leg. All right, so that's it all done other than painting and finishing if you wanna do that. Now this is pressure treated wood. I know it's not gonna last very long. If I get a season or two out of it, that's fine. It was all just scrap. So I just put these rails on the side here. Those I did not let into the leg. They're just surface mounted. I just nailed in. You can use screws if you like. And you know, the measurements here will depend on what you have for pots. These are 2 gallon pots, but the configuration may be slightly different for you. But just to give you a rough idea, the legs are about 14 inches tall. The length is about 32, and the outside measurement is almost 14. And then the space between the rails is about 2 inches, and same to the bottom here, so it's 2, 2, 2. So you know, it's just a really rough and ready kind of planter. What's nice is you can remove these easily and put them back in. So if the plant dies or you have to repot it or whatever, it's easy to get in and out. The water will drain through, so that's not a problem. And I think once I paint it, I'll fill in any cracks and stuff with caulk, and I'll paint it, do a quick little sanding, paint it, and I think it'll be nice for a season.